Hello and welcome to another episode of Basic Stuff, and today it's gonna be about how to play in, or how to play and how not to play in, in Cyclone. So you just, I have two replays. The first one is how not to, and the second one will be about how you should progress as a team. Of course, we are talking about randoms, nobody or not everyone will listen, but in general, you can do your own effort and try it, and maybe you're lucky your team listens to you, or is going to do the right stuff, what I'm proposing or what I know from evidence. Okay, so this is the one game. Ah, no. Some other general facts, sorry. Just be aware that in Cyclone, a battleship gets significantly stronger. If you are a battleship and it's Cyclone, then you are one of the big fishes that you are usually already are, but in Cyclones you are even more. Cyclone has a detectability range of 8 kilometers, and yeah, that makes it quite comfortable for you. Because you can see every cruiser when he's approaching, there's no firing behind some curtain or something, or unless the enemy has radar. So that's the only difference where I would say that it is a bit in favor of cruisers, but we have some battleships as well who have radar, right? So it doesn't matter too much. Alright, the first thing I want to talk about is the preparation. So, you see a timer. Normally at 5 minutes before the cyclone starts, there's a timer, and that's normally the time of preparation. I'm here, I thought, okay, I should go C, but C is secured, so I'm just turning towards the north because I'm seeing some ships approaching here. In Cyclone, you also want to clear the flanks. So normally you want to group up sooner or later and then fight the enemy. But you have to be always clear that the flanks are safe, because otherwise the enemy has so much fun by getting into your flanks, and that's what I want to prevent in, yeah, intercept these guys, because they are likely to go around here, and if we have to go fight for B, and that's when everybody is going or should go in here, then you have a clear flank at least. So my goal is, yeah, just intercept them, stop them, make them retreat, whatever. That would be the perfect thing. And that's what I'm going to do right now. I have no fear of another replica. I have a hybrid secondary build. The Des Moines is also no challenger unless I'm really low HP and have to show a lot of broadside. And my dispersion is fucking me over. That can also happen, but that's it. So I'm already made my mind up what to do. When the 5 minutes are over, the visibility will decrease slowly, so it's not like it's from one to the next moment 8 kilometers. No, it will decrease, like, I don't know which pattern it is, but it will decrease. And there's also, you see in the visibility, then it shows how far you can see with your eyes, so to say. So that's the first thing: prepare or clear the flank, make them retreat, whatever. And as soon as you got that, you are trying to assemble and group up with other ships. And if you can, just make that in, or let your team know, yeah, we are fighting about B, so don't go alone, group up, and then we are fighting. Especially, I mean, a cyclone is a lot of randomized stuff going on. You don't know where the enemies are exactly and what they are up to, but in the end, the more ships in one place, the better. Because if like two ships detect another ship in 8 kilometers and he's practically alone, he gets just murdered normally. Also, like for ships like Hindenburg, it's really awesome because you can come really close in a short time. It's an extreme danger for battleships that don't react right on time. All right, so there we have the Des Moines. I'm turning away. I don't want to go completely ham on them. I let my secondaries work, which makes it also pretty easy for me. And yeah, first I want to get rid of the Des Moines. Realize that it is a big issue now. But yeah, you see it. And after I get rid of the Des Moines, my plan is to kill the Republic. And yeah, sadly, the Des Moines is able to get behind the island, and the Republic is covering him. So, not the best times for me. So I'm getting undetected. Now you can see how far you can
All stations requesting fire on
or
the
how far
designated
your
target.
visibility is going. It's still 35 kilometers, so it's slowly decreasing. So the Republic, I need to either kill or like make retreat. That's the main goal I'm having here. You'll see some people doing some weird stuff. This Cleveland doesn't react. You should have like turned around, maybe get in the center here, or maybe group up with the Moskva and the whatever Brünn and Bismarck and secure the sea flank, while this rest should go for the middle. My goal here with the Republic is knocking out his front turret so it can show some more broadside and make my secondaries work, but yeah, Buffalo never heard of a deadly Republic. Well, I got pretty lucky and I knocked out the turret completely, and now this Republic is completely forced to show so much broadside that I can delete him quite easily because penetration is overmatching the turtle back immediately. And there we go. So that's the Republic dead. Now I turn north. So the detectability went down now to 8 kilometers. Now I'm going north, and I'm trying to prevent the Des Moines of going around here if he is, and if not, then I'm going here. While my team is, yeah, these DDs are making a real critical error. They are way too close without any support. So in a destroyer, you don't want to be the first ones. The destroyer in Cyclone is really hard to play, in my opinion. You can be radared, you can as I said, it's 8 kilometers, so if you have 5.9 and you're steaming full ahead and the enemy does the same, you don't have enough time to turn around without getting spotted. And that's exactly what happened to the gearing there. He got just spotted by an enemy Fletcher, and that's it. So you can assume, or by the looks of the on the minimap, you can just maybe throw some preemptive torps and yeah, that's it probably. So I'm telling my team crew up to rush them, so let's go to the second point, which is the grouping. Sadly, the only one that is willing to do so is the Friedrich. That Bismarck is already dead if he doesn't delete the Neptune, which is unfortunate. That Cleveland, okay, is doing somewhat okay, but I'm not sure. In the Cleveland, the next replay will be in the Cleveland, I can tell you. Cleveland or these support cruisers are really not the best ones. The Rune never watched the minimap, it looks like, because otherwise he would have helped here in the middle. Rune in this can be also quite good brawler if need be, but yeah, doesn't help. So the Des Moines isn't here anymore, so means I'm going into the middle to help out my team. That's Hindenburg. Shit his pants. Instead of rushing these guys, he's sitting full broadside onto a Musashi. Well, that's individual mistakes, but still. That Friedrich, I talked with the Friedrich and we said, okay, let's go. And yeah, you see me in the chat already saying what a throw, and yeah, you can imagine why why this is a throw. So the Cleveland is dead, Bismarck is dead, they all fought alone, and the Rune is somewhere useless on the edge of the map. I don't know. And the Hindenburg, yeah, he had the fitting name. He's absolutely a loser in my opinion, but okay. So, I'm trying to help my Friedrich. The main issue here is the Hindenburg. That's the first target I'm going for because he has the capability of torping me. So whenever I'm spotting him, he's the one I'm going for. Maintaining an angle and yeah. Okay, there he is. Putting the secondaries on him. Stopping here. Because if you're in a minority in ships, then you wanna fight them one by one. Also really important. I mean, of course you can rush into, but then do it just against battleship, not against cruisers that have a strong torpedo loadout like the Hindenburg has. Hindenburg stands no chance against Republik, so just be aware of that. Friedrich turned around. I think he did the right thing there, because it's always a bit awkward. You don't want to run into the Hindenburgs. So now I'm starting with the Richelieu and let the secondaries work on the rest. I'm reversing a bit. Should have repaired a bit earlier. Musashi is really an issue, same like Yamato for the Republic, because he can overmatch you. And I saw the Des Moines here, who's right behind me, that Moskva is trying some stupid shit. He never will win the fight against the Des Moines unless he knows what he's doing, but yeah, the angle he's coming in, the Des Moines takes his back turret, he loads AP and wrecks him, because he has to go around and show broadside. Alright, Hipper. So always the cruisers first, the same like in randoms, killed the Hipper, but doesn't matter, down here the Rhone goes down again, also because he fought alone, and if you fight alone, that's really an issue. Musashi got killed, and there's still a Friedrich, and I have, the main issue is now the Des Moines. I tried to delete at the beginning, especially now when he has broadside on me. And I have to give broadside to two ships, and yeah, apparently you won't survive this, or I won't survive this. 9k volley, I mean I needed one or two volleys, but yeah. You see how quickly you can wrap up the damage. What I didn't like was the Hindenburgs just sitting there. They have no clue how strong the ship is, especially against like ships, like battleships. Just go full speed, go ham, and battleships will have a hard time. Of course, the Republic is just the perfect counter, but or Yamato, but like Montanas and Kofers, they can all hurt you, but that's it. Alright, I'm going over to the next replay then. Alright, here we are. As I said, this time in the Cleveland, so a totally different story. The deployment the enemy has right now is way superior than ours, for example. And I'm the one who's not going first in. I make sure that I'm not going first in. I'm just a supporter. And it's really important stuff. And now I'm spotted, I know I'm radar, I can just radar and that's fine. Shiratsu, you can't see me, but that's the only advantage I have over the over other ships, that I have a radar, but it's only like for 20 seconds, so not such a big thing. My aim is a bit questionable here, but yeah, Cleveland on range, always a bit hard. Right, popping my hydro, and now I'm making sure that all my guys are coming with me, and they are really all in this one plop. I think it's not 100% torpedoes, direct front. Perfect, but it's better than not grouping up. Because if these guys are smart, they are just going on my flank, and I can just hope that some people would challenge them. But I'm going in here behind that Akatsuki. He lays a smoke, which is also pretty good for me. Tried to help him with the Shiratsuyu, but couldn't. He's playing, of course, a risky game there. I think the enemy has... No, he has no radar, so it's pretty okay. I think the smoke is pretty safe. Just you have to be aware of torps, but you can mitigate that by the hydro that I'm running right now. And yeah, I can sit in there. That's, of course, a fortunate thing. Yeah, that Akatsuki has no... Okay, that Azashio is a bit questionable. Why he's charging in, so you don't do this normally. And I think he's going down. Yep. So that's one destroyer less. We don't know the positions of these ships here, and especially these three. So, yeah, we have one guy, two, three torpedoes that are going to the north flank, which makes total sense in my opinion. So I'm really glad that someone cares about the flanks, because especially on trap, exactly these flanks are really important, especially also in Cyclone. That's why I said the enemy had a quite good original deployment. Also, I spoiled a bit about fight in the Cyclone last game, but yeah, I just forgot to switch around. But that's how it is. So, King George is coming, Scharnhorst is more or less rushing him, I guess. And of course my DPM is hurting him a lot. Okay, if I hit the right part, of course, which I didn't. But now I'm switching to AP. Try to stay angled, I can bounce his 356mm guns, so that's not a big issue. And I'm staying behind the cover. I'm using this cover, I'm playing Cleveland also in Cyclone like this. Don't wanna get clapped. If the ship is on fire. King George would have been a bit smarter, he would have done something else. So, but now I'm safe, it's fine. I can sit behind the island for now. So, enemy is now going in, one by one. Nagato is trying the right thing, but the Monarch is intercepting already. And yeah, it's like Cyclone and... yeah. I don't know, the Scharnhorst had probably not enough HP. Otherwise, that would have been a perfect playground for him. That Nürnberg is doing some questionable things, but I'm radaring him just because of that. Now I'm in his visibility range anyways, so going full AP here. Don't know what his plan is, but it's a bit questionable, I would say. Reversing broadside aus, gets you killed most of the time. But of course he's resetting me, I'm using my... the ship is on fire. Heal here now. Also, you should have AP loaded most of the time. Also in the cruiser. So, I'm turning a bit away in case there is someone charging in. That's at least my plan. As I said, I'm not the one who's going in front, even though there's only one battleship left, but still, I'm not the one who goes in front. Torpedoes to port. Yeah, that are Nürnberg torpedoes, so nothing to worry about. I'm waiting there for the Miyoko. He's coming around soonish. No, he's not spotted, sadly. So yeah, our battleships wrecked the enemies completely. So. Yeah, the game is won, and just due to the grouping up, it's so simple. Of course, if you're a good player, you can maybe turn something around, but not always. If your team splits up like on the Republic game, there's no chance that you can carry this. And the slightest crossfire will kill you. It's sad, but it's the truth, so yeah. Nothing you can do about it. Right, Nagato coming in, the Cyclone is vanishing, so I can start like playing whatever I want. That Nagato was practically useless for his team and the whole Cyclone. He was way too far away, and now he's paying the price for it. Nobody's spotting for him, and that's how you not do it. Grouping up, no matter how bad your team is, will significantly improve your chances of winning. That's for sure. So let's. I'm letting this play down until the end. Yeah, hope you understand what I mean. Hope I could bring it closer to you. If you have some comments, just write in below. Maybe have some additional tips and tricks. I don't never say that all what I say is 100% correct, but of course there are situational differences. But yeah, I think the main parts I spoke about, and I think I can consider them quite true. And yeah, you can, if you have a different opinion or anything or another advice, just post it in the comments. That would be appreciated. Alright, yeah, now Shiratsuyu is the only one left. And I guess that's too boring to show until he's revealing himself. So yeah, thanks for watching this. Hope you enjoyed it. And yeah, see you next time. Bye bye, your Eito.